first, illustrate the problem of the short-termism in our country generation. The second, recognise that this generation has a duty to alleviate the burdens and challenges faced by the next. Third, describe the ways of committing to the long term. Fourth, examine the causes and symptoms of political myopia. And finally, outline how the coalition government is shifting towards a longer term perspective. Politicians are often accused of being obsessed with the short term, but it should be obvious that politics is not uniquely guilty. In commercial and personal life, short term temptations confront longer term benefits too. In firms and in financial markets, the temptation to drive for short term profits can sometimes undermine long term prosperity. The hunt for annual and quarterly economic returns gives my power. It's a take it to excess, but focus on the instability and diversity to lower returns over a longer time frame. When remuneration packages are tied to the performance of shares over a very short time span, the long term result is often a weaker corporate sector. The best companies, the ones built to last, look well beyond quarter on quarter profits. In terms of bringing about the horizon shift we need, corporate development matters at least as much as political development. And as individuals, most of us are acutely aware that short-term desires confront our long-term interests. This is why a new problem concern, temptation of individual, is part of the human condition. John Stuart Mill pointed out that men very often reach for the nearer good, even though they know it to be less valuable. In fact, it makes wild declared the only way to get rid of temptation is simply to yield. It's hard to know historically whether we are more myopic than our ancestors, but it's clear that the range of temptations is greater in a world of plenty. Just think for a moment about the food and drink being offered for sale all around us all the time. The range of entertainment available to us has widened beyond recognition. TV, computer games, cinema, social networking sites, music quickly downloaded onto your iPod. According to Ofcom, the average UK citizen now spends almost half their waking hours watching TV or using mobiles and other communication devices. There's in fact so much available that we're now consuming these goods simultaneously. The typical citizen crams 8 hours and 48 minutes of media consumption into just over 7 hours during the average day. We're no longer simply multitasking, we're multi-consuming too. But don't get me wrong, this is also good. The choice and opportunities of modern life are great blessings. I don't subscribe to the view that the expansion in our choices of entertainment, lifestyle, consumption is intrinsically corrosive. Choice is good. But the question is whether